He has sent his prophets to rescue you. But you don't want to be rescued, because the one who wants to rescue you, you will have to obey them. If I come to you as the one who rescues you, if the prophets are coming to you to rescue you, you will have to obey. When I say leave the world, when I say donate, when I say give charity, when I say keep love in the first place, you still want to hate people. You still want to accuse people. You don't want to give. Your deeds are not godly. If so many things you want to do in disobedience and by yourself, and you say that you have faith and you're righteous, then you must understand that you're still unrighteous when you have not yet obeyed the Lord. If you don't understand the meaning of obeying the Lord, you must know that whatever the prophets have said, that is the obedience. Why? Because God is the all-knowing God, and He will share His secret plans only to the prophets. Without sharing it to the prophets, He will not do anything in your life. And to the same prophets, to the same apostles, to the same pastors and preachers, you're blaming them. You're not listening to them. You're not obeying them. You're not ready to give on the altar of God. If so many things are going in your heart, in your mind, in your life, you're listening to someone else. You're not listening to those people who are praying for you. You're not giving on the altar of God, but you're very happy to please men, women, boyfriend, girlfriend. You're happy to please the people of the world. You are not willing to please the Lord. Then still you are unrighteous. Are you truly righteous to receive Jeremiah 29 verse 11, to receive God's perfect plan for you? Because He is the all-knowing God. Only He can have perfect plan for you. Now the Lord has plans for everyone, and He may say there is no marriage for you. For some, He may say remarry. For some, He will say there is no marriage, but you must serve the Lord. For some, He will say marry. For some, there is ministry. And for everyone, there is ministry of Holy Spirit. For some, there is kingdom financing. And for everyone, there is sowing of seed. So kingdom financing is for everyone. You must give your finances. Because money you need, money you give. Prayers you need, prayers you give. Blessings you need, blessings you give. Love you need, love you give. Whatever you want, you give others. You want prayers, pray for others. You want money, you want financial breakthroughs, whatever you have, bring it on the altar of God. And bring it freely as a blessing, not to take it back, not to accuse anyone, not to say that this is not my will. It should be your will to give for the ministry of Holy Spirit. It should be your will. Hallelujah.